I'm Arthur Cupins. I'm an engineer architect. I worked a long time for the city. Now I work private in a company of construction. And I enjoy life and a lot of things in the past that I've done. I was also involved in the Council of Architects from Europe, from National Council. I was president of the Flemish Council of Architects and in the Council of the Province of Antwerp also. So there we did a lot of work against for the way of working of architects and the relation with the government.
Would you tell somewhat about your architectural work and your input in Antwerp?
I worked a lot in the urbanism sector. Let's say not directly buildings, but I designed the mayor and the furniture around it. And also I worked on the structural plan of the plan director, like they say, of Antwerp, with an whole team. I was not alone because it's a specialty. We have sociology, economists to make the future for Antwerp with all the green spaces and the relation we have to be the people and the city, work and the city, pleasure and the city, all this kind of things we have to put in harmony and well structured.
Would you tell somewhat about the Maas Museum, and you were in a jury?
Yes, I was in a jury. It was very interesting because there were over all the world there were not only national but all international architects, and there we have to choose one project. We selected five that could make more a specific plan. The first part of the competition was also sketches, and then we go further, and then afterwards we give it to the architect that make it now.
Can you say about the modern tendencies in architecture, world tendencies?
I think you can't speak about tendencies. What we try to do in Antwerp is when there are new buildings that has to be constructed in a old city, that it must be in respect of the existing buildings and in harmony also height and depth from the existing structures. And also, for example, also to take out parts that, because in the past all the center of blocks of houses were filled up with reconstructions and other construction, and that we try to redesigned as open spaces to have more green in the city. Yeah. Another thing that I'm proud of it that I did is that I prepared the law that we have in Antwerp to have all the new constructions and renovation we have to have with it. When there are flat roofs, they have to be green. Because green is against the fine dust, and also it gives oxygen to the city, and because of the thermical issue we have also, if all the, for example, I let calculate, if all the roofs, the flat roofs in Antwerp were green, the temperature will in the summer will low for two degrees. Because of the energetic and the water they can take. And it's also very interesting because when there's a lot of rain, first we don't have a peak in the water that go to the down, because the first they were absorbed by the plants on the roofs. And that's also interesting, that for no have to not have inundations in some parts of every city.
And Antwerp is a really beautiful city and a lot of nice buildings are here, but do you know some ugly buildings?
Of course. The first I think about is near our opera. There is a building that they built in the 60s. Nowadays it will be not possible to do such an early construction. It's not in relation. What I was telling now, that we try to put everything in harmony. It was a huge old building, and they put there the tower, the Antwerp Tower, as they say, with brown glasses. It's awful. It's not in relation with the classical part of the opera that's just beside.
And what are you going to do with it?
If I could, I would blow it up, but that's the problem of when you have a permission, you can't decide to turn it like that. If they asked to renovate it, or then you can say you have to knock it down. But when there's an existing building, that's also insurance you have. If you have a permission to construct, you can do it. But we try in renovations and new buildings to return back a little bit that mistakes that were made in the past in the 60s.
Yes, and as for all the buildings in the center of Antwerp, in the heart of Antwerp, mm-hmm. they really needed to be renovated, but they still
in the old city, the center, you can't build without you have to make an old note about the historical and architectural value in the past, and then they will decide if you can keep it or you will take it out. Normally we have buildings that are classified as monuments, then we can do nothing. But even when it's not classified, we have to make all a report and a study, historical study of the building, and then they say the survey that is responsible of the monument, they say we want you to keep that, or you can cover it, but you can't take it out.
As for churches, there is a lot of churches in Antwerp of different confessions, but some of them are empty and nobody uses it.
Yes, that's for me also a problem, because I saw for example in the Netherlands that they use them as housing, and so it could be only one church in Augustinuskerk near the building of the police that's now for music. But they are not property of the city, they are property of the community of churches, or the it can be the Catholic Church or another church. So if they don't you have to take him out of the religion, out of the sphere of this, they have to give permission. You can't do it like that. And other thing is, for all the renovations or restoration of the city, of the churches, it's the state and the city that who paid the more of the part. Like for the cathedral and other buildings, it's the government that we pay the restoration. Mm.
But
so it's a lot of money that goes, even if they are not used for many people.
But would you like? Do you have an idea to redesign it, maybe?
Redesign. We have to respect the church, but I dream to take to have a church to renovate it and make other functioning to it. That's more useful, not only for me. There are sufficient churches for the people who believe in God and so. But you can take a few out and make something that you respect. Let's say the building as such, but you give another function, you and life into the building. Yeah. That's what I desire to do, but that's very difficult.
But what is your idea?
But it can be like we make now a temple for music, because it's not, the acoustic is very good. But it can be housing. It can be you can make floors. You can make several things to it. But always in respect of the building. You can't make floors into it that you don't see the huge the how the building, the splendid building is. Always you have to let's see the structure and also the first function. Mm. You don't have to change that. You can't see anymore that it was before the church. No, let it. You don't have to take all the statues out because it's not a more for a religion function. No, but you can do other things.
And what is your favorite place in Antwerp?
That's very difficult to say. That's very difficult to say because there are parts in the old city that I like, but also, for example, to go to walk in the Middelheim with all the statues that one of our mayors created there. It's huge to go there. For how you, I don't know if you visited yet, but it's all with modern statues and you can see it's a beauty.
But maybe it's a mayor's street you designed?
Yeah, no, yes, but no. No, the mayor's street, it was before I designed it, it was a street with cars, and now it's only for pedestrian during the day. And that we have to make a little bit, let's say, in respect also of the buildings and to create spaces for every function for the pedestrians, also to discharge material for the shops, and also there are three zones and passing by during the night. With the night, the cars can pass. But if you see how now it is used than before, people are walking. You can walk overhead. And some days now, like today, when the sun is shining, the shops are open. I'm living there now, and already more than 15 years. And I'm surprised after 6 years. See, when I go out, and I see how many people are, because inside, and that's nice. Inside the building, you heard nothing. It's quiet.
Yes. And maybe some philosophical questions. Question: what can architect tell about people, local people?
Oh, that's very difficult because Antwerp there are so many different nationalities, and that's just. For me, it's just an opportunity and a chance, and it gives more color to the city. And even now that a lot of people are very negative because of the problems they have, but I think in the heart, the people of Antwerp are people who like other people, who like to compare, like to share. With other people, and they are proud of their city and they want to share it with other people. I think that's for me the typical Antwerp people, proud of the city but lovely to share it with other people.
And what kind of possibilities you have in Antwerp to have such multicultural atmosphere?
The only restriction is are the law that you have to have a permission to stay, but for the rest, I think the language perhaps also sometimes is also a problem because you have to communicate. It depends which work you want to do. But now I'm working with a lot of Bulgarian people, and we learned a lot, and it is going good. But yeah. They are permission to stay here and to work here. That's important. It has to be legal.
Yes, but as for architecture, I don't see some influences from other parts of the world.
There can be, but I'm against. It's in Willerek, but it's a religion part, but they make it an Hindu temple. That's very strange here. Because you have your architecture that's typical for this country. You will not make a rancho like in Argentina or in Spain. Here it will be like Disney. Yeah. And that's for example, the difference, if I may say, between Dubai and Antwerp. Antwerp has a historical part, is grown. We have the old part, we have the part, the circle of the 19th century with its own architecture and its evolution. And that you have to respect. And if you make constructions that have nothing to do with our past or what I said with harmony, For example, if you say this place and I will paint here the building in orange, it will be very, very, very awful.
Yeah.
Even if, for example, in India, it will be very nice with the weather and so that you have an orange building or in a sunny country. But more of the time now we have sun, but it's more gray, and you have to respect the identity of every part of the world. And that's for me the issue for an architect, to be humble. And with his architecture, he can do his thing, and he can try to integrate his way of viewing the architecture, but it has to be with respect with the environment and the other architecture. That's for me a good architect, to be humble in the first place.
Okay, thank you so much. Yeah.